Hi, it's Ted Tripod Jones here, and in this video you are going to learn how to make your photos go from ordinary to great. In the world of photography, there are plenty of great resources available to both new and experienced photographers alike. There are many programs, e-guides, books, videos, and other resources available. This set of tips contains some of the best advice for helping a good photographer become a great photographer. 1. If you are planning to take pictures outside, reevaluate the lighting every 10 minutes, as lighting is constantly changing. Adjust your angle to get the best possible shot and illuminate the features that you are trying to highlight. Planning in advance is very important for producing quality photos. 2. When showing off your photographs, make sure to keep your less than perfect pictures at home. You do not want people to see your subpar work, you only want them to see your best work. Delete any pictures on your camera that you do not want anyone else to see. 3. Here's a great photography tip. Shutter speeds can make the difference between a good and bad photo, so learn more about them. There are different settings on a camera. These include M, A, P and SP means program mode. This setting is automatic, and it adjusts your shutter and speed for you by itself. The P setting should be utilized when you are unsure about what you will be going to shoot. 4. Another great photography tip is to make sure your shots have depth in them. An easy way to achieve that is to be sure that you have a background, a middle ground, and a foreground. Having all three of these will give your pictures a sense of atmospheric perspective. 5. Remember to look for unusual things. It can either be a small detail or a strange situation. Learn how to represent what strikes you as unusual or original in the world you see. As you practice, you will be able to recognize what makes a good subject for your pictures. 6. Try out different lenses. A cool lens you can try is the fisheye lens. With the fisheye lens you end up with a lot of neat distortion around the center of the image. It can make your photographs much more interesting. 7. While taking indoor photos under fluorescent lighting, make sure the camera has the appropriate white balance settings. If you want to take pictures under fluorescent lights, compensate for it by pushing the tone of your picture toward the red side of the color scale, since this type of lighting gives a slight blue or green hue to the picture. 8. Experiment with different speeds for your camera's shutter. Do not be afraid of hurting your equipment. Speed it up and slow it down. See how the speed affects the final picture. Take a lot of practice shots, and get familiar with how your camera will react at different shutter speeds. 9. Get views of different angles of the subject or scene that you are shooting. Many amateurs will not take the time to move around the subject to find the best angle. If you do, you'll find there are many different photos to be taken of one subject. 10. Try adding one or two stops when you shoot objects like snow or beaches to make sure that they are receiving the proper amount of exposure. Scenes that are very white or even very black will try to fool your camera's light meter and you will need to make adjustments to compensate. 11. Experiment with a variety of shutter speed settings, your flash feature and lighting to learn how they affect your pictures. Learn about exposure to improve your overall photography. Digital cameras. 1. When you are taking photos of landscapes, create an appearance of depth. Foreground is very important in landscape photography. Place an object in the foreground to create a sense of depth and scale. If you set a small aperture, one that is not greater than f/8. For many digital cameras that are made for consumers, or f/16, on a full frame SLR, you will notice that your foreground and background look sharp. 2. Don't be afraid to experiment. With digital cameras, you can now store an incredible amount of photos. Try it out. Don't be afraid to set up your camera at a stream one day and play around with the effect to see what kind of photos you get. It can be a great way to learn what works and what doesn't. 3. Do not allow your camera batteries to run low because you never know when a photo opportunity will occur. Digital cameras can suck up a lot of battery power. The LCD screen has a lot to do with this. Make sure you have your batteries fully charged. Another good suggestion is to bring along spare camera batteries so that you will never miss a photo opportunity. 4. Often digital cameras will have a flash option that responds to dim light, making the feature available automatically. Auto flash is great for amateur photographs, But for a cleaner, more professional look, you should have an external unit with a broader range for your camera flash. Look at your camera and determine whether or not it features a hot shoe near the top. This is where the external flash unit attaches to the camera. If your camera can accommodate the external flash, bring it with you to the camera store to find the right model. After reading these tips, you can begin to understand what it takes to become a great photographer. There is a lot of information to be had and you need to know how to apply it. With this in mind, you can refine your own methods and start taking better photographs. If you like this video, why not click the like button below and also subscribe to my YouTube channel.